हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? वेलकम टू मेहदी इंग्लिश स्कूल. माई सेल्फ नीलोफर मिस एंड माई सब्जेक्ट इज मैथमेटिक्स. सो एज यू नो, दिस ऑनलाइन लेक्चर इज फॉर द क्लास 2. सो आई होप दैट यू ऑल आर रेडी टू अटेंड द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस, राइट? एंड प्लीज डू होमवर्क ऑफ ऑल द थिंग्स that I doing, that we are doing in the videos. Note down all the things into the maths fair book and the chapter number 10. Now, as you know this thing, that before we start our lecture, I always show you one quote, and here is the quote, that do what you love. What do you mean by this quote? Do what you love. It means whatever the things you are doing, if you are studying, just love your study. If you are writing something, love your writing. If you read something, love your reading. So do what you love, so it will give you the best result. So please just keep this quote always with you, that do what you love. Now we are in chapter number 10, and the name of this chapter is measurement, right? So in the previous lecture we are measuring how to length. We are measuring what? We are measuring that how we can measure the length, right? So that first of all, let's do revision of the previous topic first. So if any students have any doubt regarding that topic, so it will be clear. So let's do revision of the previous lecture first, and then we are going to the today's topic. So now the revision of the previous day's lecture is complete. So here is the, let's start the today's topic. Here is, you can see in the picture which animal it is. Can you identify? Can you know the name of this fish? It is a fish or animal or something else? I hope you all know this creature. This is a shark, and you can see the length of it. It is measured here. So the length of this shark is 33 meters. What do you mean by 33 meters? I told you one thing also before, that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. How much? 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. But here is 33 meters. What it means? It means 3300 centimeters is equal to 33 meters. This much long it is. Now you can just assume this, that how long the shark it is. So this is the concept of the length, that how you can measure the length. We have so much, I have so many worksheets for you, so you can easily understood the thing, that what do you mean by measurement, and especially in the length. Our today's topic is the length, right? So let's move to the further. Now here is some tools, some things are there, and I put that things on the ruler. I put that things on the scale, right? In your language, ruler, it means the scale. So here is number one. You can see here, number one, and you identify which thing it is. So this one is a pencil. What it is? This thing is a pencil. So how much long it is? You have to start measuring with the zero. As you see here, we are starting measuring the thing with the zero. And how long the pencil is? Can you measure it? Can you see on the scale that what is it? It is exactly the long. See, I'm showing you that how long the pencil is. See, now you can read the digit, which digit it is. So it is the pencil is 6 centimeter long. How you can read this? You can read this number 1 as a pencil is a long 6 cm. This is 6 cm long the pencil is. I hope you understood this thing. Now the number 2 is a glue. I'll show you. See this thing. This is the glue. Here is number 2. And this is the glue. I put that glue bottle on the ruler, on the scale. So starting measuring with the 0. And how long it is? This glue bottle is long as 3 cm. Here you can read the 3 number. So how long it is? So the glue bottle is 3 cm long. You can write down this way that a glue bottle is 3 cm long. Now the next one is a spoon. In the number 3, here is a spoon. You can see on the screen, this one is a spoon. So I'll show you to zoom the screen. See this, how long the spoon is. Here you can see the number 3 is. So the spoon is start measuring with the 0 number. Here you can see we are starting measuring with the 0 and it ends at the number 4. So how long the spoon is, how long it is? So the spoon is long as 4 cm. You have to write down this way. The spoon is long as 4 cm. This way you have to write down. Now the comb is there, hair comb. So how long it is? I'll show you by zooming it. See, here is the number 4. So you can easily identify. We have to start measuring with the 0 number. With what number we have to start measuring? We have to start measuring with number 0. And how long the comb is? You can see very well, very clearly that how long the comb it is. So the comb is long as 5 cm. How much long the comb is? The length of the comb is 5 cm. I hope that you all understood this thing, that how you measure the thing with the use of the scale. That is very easy thing. And now, after explaining the examples, you can measure different thing. Whatever the thing you have to measure by yourself. You have to measure through the scale. You have to use the scale and you have to measure the thing. You can measure your finger. You can measure the table. You can measure the chair. You can measure the books, eraser, sharpener. Whatever thing you can see around it to you, you have to measure it. And if it is length longer than the 100 cm, you have to measure it in the meter. 100 cm, it means the 1 meter. Just keep this in your mind, that thing is very important. Now, let's move to the number 5. I'll show you by zooming it. So this one is a crayon. Number 5, here you can see, this is the orange crayon. And you have to measure that crayon with the help of the scale, that how long this crayon it. This is the crayon color. So you have to start measuring with the 0 till it ends. So the ending point is at the 2 cm. So how long this crayon is? So this crayon is long as the 2 cm. How much long this crayon is? You all are using the crayons to fill the color in pictures, right? You all are using these types of crayon. And I hope that you all have these types of crayon, because you are at home, no school is there. So you just color, you all like coloring the pictures. So I think you all have the colors. And if you want to measure, you can measure the thing. Some have a small crayon, some have a big crayon. So you have to measure with the help of the scale. So your concept will be more clear, right? Now, students, I hope that the concept is clear to you all. I have one more worksheet for you. As I told you, here is a sharpener that you all are using to sharp your pencil, right? So you have to put on the scale. Starting point will be must on the zero, and you have to check this, where is the ending point it is. So here you can see the ending point is at the exactly 3. So the sharpener is long as the 3 cm. How long the sharpener is? The sharpener is 3 cm long. Now the paper pin, which pin it is? We are using this paper pin. So you have to put first part of this pin at the zero, and you have to measure where is the ending point is. So here the ending point is at the 5. So how long the paper clip is? It is 5 cm long. Now here is the scissor. You all are using the scissor and you all know this. So you have to measure the scissor with the help of the scale. Starting point must on the zero, and here where it ends on the 7.5. Why I write 7.5? Because 7 is ends here, but it ends on exactly after the 5 points, right? 7 after the 5. So you can write down 7.5. So this way, students, you have to measure the things. Whatever things you like, you can measure it. Whatever things around you, you can see. So you can measure you. In your phone, that is why you are watching this video, you have a phone into your hand. So you can measure the phone only. Whatever thing you like, you can measure, and you have to make a list of the 10 things which you are measuring around it to you, not from the video. You have to just measure the different things into your home, and you have to make a list. For example, it is a book, it is a spoon, whatever it is your shoe, it is your nail, whatever it is you like, you have to make the list of the 10 things, and you have to measure it, and you have to send it to you as a homework. So I will also send you in the WhatsApp group this homework, but you have to just send me in as a homework. So I hope you understood these things. Now nowadays we are maintaining the social distancing, right? With shopping for essential, whenever you go, you hear the word social distancing. What it means? So see, this 2 person is there, and the distance between them must be a 2 meter. How much? 2 meter distance must be there. So this way you can understood that how the social distance you have to maintain. You have to just keep distance with each and everything. You have to maintain distance. Whenever you go outside, you have to maintain the social distancing. It is called the social distance. I hope you understood this thing. Now, in the school, if you remember, each and every standard, whenever you was in first standard, we measure your height, that how, what is your length, how long you are. So you are increasing. Whenever you are growing, your height will be increased. Whenever you if you are in the first standard and your height is maximum 110 cm, so if it is 110 cm, whenever you will come on the second standard, it will increased. In the first standard your height was 110. Whenever you come in the second standard, it will be must improve 5 or 10 cm, right? So as your standard increase, your height is also increased. So this way, if you measure your height, you can see different. Whenever you measure your height, it always increasing order. It will give you a increasing order number. So this way, you have to learn about this increasing point. You can measure your length also, your height also. So this way, we have to go with the length topic. I hope you understood this. Very well. I have a length measurement. So let's start with the here. 1 centimeter. CM. It means a 10 millimeter. You can write down in mm. 1 decimeter. It means a 10 centimeter. 1 meter. It means a 10 decimeter. So this is the just information. This thing will not come in the exam, but that thing is just for the information for you. So I hope you understood this. Now here is 1 decimeter. If you don't understood, so here is the scale. 1 to 10. It means a 1 decimeter. You can call it a decimeter. So I hope that you all very well understood this concept of the length. Now please write down 10 things you have to measure. Write down the name of these things which you will measure and how long the thing is, you have to write down beside it, right? So I hope you will enjoy this lecture. Please. So the revision is complete. Now you can see what this person is, in what they are standing on, which thing it is. Have you any idea about this, that what thing it is and why this person is standing on it? Do you have any idea? So this is the weight machine, right? Weight machine for what? For us. This weight machine can measure our weight. And here you can see this difference number. You can see on this weight machine, this is the kilograms. Here is 10 kilograms, here is 20 kilograms, here is 30 kilograms. If this point will come on 20, so your weight is 20 kilogram. If it comes on 70, your weight is 70 kilogram. If your weight is come on 120, then your weight is 120 kilogram. So the person is standing on this weight machine. What is the weight of that person? See this. The weight of that person is 120 kilogram. What? So you all are knowing about the weight machine, that we sometimes doing our weight also. In school days also, in the PT teacher, your PT teacher is taking your weight every year in the first, second, in the second standard, third standard, and your weight increased, right? As you growing up, your weight will increase. So this way, you can measure your weight also. So to measure different things, different types of machine you can use. This weight machine is for us to measure our weight, the human being's weight. Any particular person's weight you have to measure, then you can use this weight machine. Understood this? Now here you can see in this picture, this boy is standing on the weight machine. On which he is standing? He is standing on the weight machine. And he is trying to measure his weight, that how much kilogram he is, what is the weight of that boy is. Now what is weight? We are talking about weight, but you know what do you mean by weight? So here is one definition of the weight is given. So you have to note down this definition of the weight into the rough book. This is compulsory for you all to write down this definition of weight into the rough fare book. That is compulsory. Now, weight is a measure of heavy, how heavy something is. So, in one time you cannot understood, we have to repeat it twice or thrice so you can understood about the weight. So, weight is a measure of, weight is a measure of how heavy something is. It means we are measuring our weight. So it shows that how heavy the person is. Why we are measuring our weight? So it shows that how heavy the person is. What is the weight of something? For example, the chair, right? It has also a weight. Everything has a weight. Your bag, your school bag has a weight, a water bottle. If you are just measuring is with water or without water, both the measure things will show you the different numbers, right? Now, what is the basic unit of measuring? It is a mass, and you can call it a gram. The thing which is not that much heavy, so you have to measure it in a gram. How to measure? You have to measure it in a gram. Here is, and how you can write down in a short form? You can write down gram in a short form this way, in a bracket, in a small letter you have to write down g, and gram is a basic unit of measuring. Mass, it means the thing. So this way you have to measure the thing. Now what about kilograms? 1 kilogram is the mass of a bag or sugar or a large heavy books. Something is very large, and if you think about it, the weight is too much. It is heavy thing. So the light thing you can measure in a gram, or heavy thing you have to measure in a kilogram. Understood this thing, students? Small things you have to, light things you have to measure in a grams, or heavy things, a big things you have to measure in a kilogram. Just keep this concept in your mind, that how it works. So let's take some examples of gram and kilogram, so you will be better understood this thing. Now here is the weight machine. So this is a weight machine for what? For us, for any person. So whenever you go for buying something like sugar, rice, anything else, cereals, right? The shop near at your home. So these types of weight machine they have. The fruit seller have, the vegetable seller have. That types of weight machine is there. They are one type of basket they are putting on this machine. They just put the things that how much you want. Like potatoes. So how much potatoes you want? 1 kg, 2 kg, tomatoes, potatoes, everything, fruits, apples. So anything, whenever you go for buying, the shopkeeper always ask you how much you want. What question he will ask to you? He will ask to you the one question, that how much you want. It is a 500 grams, it is a 1 kilogram, it is a 2 kilogram. So as per your requirement, you are giving answer that I want 1 kilogram apples. So they are measuring that 1 kilogram apples. They measure on this weight machine and then give you. Or they are giving you, just count the apples and give you in the bag. They first measure the thing. They first measure, they first put the things on this machine. They are doing weight of that thing, and then they give us, right? Now here is metric units for mask. You have to just, this is for the information, milligram. It takes 1000 milligram to make a gram. 1000 milligram, it means a 1 gram. About the paper clip, so it is a 1000 gram, it means a 1 kilogram. These types of, you know, weight machine, you can see this is the heavy side will go down, or a light side will go upside, heavy side will go down. I will show you with the help of some picture, so you will be better understood that how you can do it. Now here is some, I have some picture for this. Here is one side is a watermelon and one side is a pumpkin. So here, this is meters. See this, this is the straight one. It means the weight of watermelon and the weight of pumpkin is same. You can see here is equal to sign is there. It means both are same weight. And one thing I want to show you here, you can see this here, this black point here, that is a straight, इट मीन्स बोथ साइड्स आर इक्वल, नॉट एनीवन इज़ हैवी और नॉट एनीवन इज़ लाइट, बोथ आर इज़ द सेम वेट. ओके, नाउ हियर इज़ एप्पल एंड हियर इज़ ऑरेंज. सो विच फ्रूट इज़ हैवी, आई विल शो यू बाई जूमिंग इट. सी दिस, दैट ब्लैक लाइन इज फ्रॉम द हैवी साइड, इट्स मूव टू द हैवी साइड. सो द एप्पल इज गो डाउन एंड ऑरेंज विल गो अप. सो विच साइड इज अ हैवी और विच साइड इज अ लाइट? सो द वेट ऑफ एप्पल एंड हियर इज द वेट ऑफ ऑरेंज. सो द वेट ऑफ एप्पल इज अ हैवी साइड, दैट वाइज द ब्लैक लाइन गो इन फ्रंट ऑफ द एप्पल. नाउ हियर, हियर यू कैन सी, हियर इज एप्पल इज वन साइड एंड टू बनानास इज देयर. सो विच थिंग्स वेट इज मोर? Apple is going upside and this black line is moving to the banana. It means the weight of the banana is more than the apple. So this way, this is just for example, so you can better understood this thing. Now here I am showing you some machines for the weight. These types of weight machine you can see around your, near around the shop you have. So they have these types of machine. Nowadays fruit seller, vegetable seller, they all have these types of weight machine. Because all the things we are buying, first of all we just give the some measurement that how much we want the thing is. It is a kilogram or a gram or how much we want. First of all we have to give the measurement that how much the thing we want, right? So this all are the measurement equipments that we can use to measure the thing, that we use to measure the weight for anything, whatever it is. It is a sugar, it is a rice, it is a cereals, it is something else, flour, whatever the thing we want. First of all the shopkeeper must measure the thing, then they give to us. Now you can see is sometimes the shopkeeper have this types of also weight machine, you can call it. So here is two sides is there. So have you any idea which is the heavy side or which is the light side? Do you have any idea which side is heavy or which side is light? This one is a go down. See this, here is, this is sides go down and this will go up like a seashore, right? This is the heavy side and this one is a light side. You can see here this side will go up, the side, this arrow will go down from this side. So here the thing is that is a heavy, and here whatever the thing is, that thing is a light thing. Now here is, now you can see me, which side is a heavy and which side is a light? This one is a heavy. See that moves around down, this sides go down. So this one is a light side and here is a heavy side. Now here you can see both the sides are equal. So both the weight is equal weight. Whenever the equal weight is there, so this types of till will, it will stand straight, it will not move anywhere, not a left or not a right, it will stand straight. So it means there is a equal weight. What it showing to us, it will showing us that this is the equal weight. Now here is something showing to you, this is the original machine I'm showing you. I hope you see somewhere. Now which is the heavy side or which is the light side? Have you any idea which one is a heavy side or which one is a light side? So this one is a heavy side because it's go down and this will come up. So this side is a heavy side and this side is a light side. I hope you understood this thing very well, students. And just let's see some more example. See here I am showing you one picture of this vegetable seller. That boy is selling the vegetable and it has this types of weight machine. You can see. So he will measure the things in this weight machine first and then he will give you. See this, here is the apples and here is, you have to put weight, that weights will come, that is a 1 kilogram or 500 gram or 250 gram, that will weight you have to put here, then it will go equally. Now see this, I will show you the electronic weight machine also. This way they can put the things on this weight machine and then they can measure the weight and then they can give you. This way they are measuring the weight. Now here is, this one is a lion and this one is a monkey. So whose weight is more? Lion side is a downside and monkey's side is a upside. So lion is a heavy side and the monkey's side is a light side. H it means heavy and L it means light. Now please students, write down all the things into the fair book and do revision of all the things. Watch the video very carefully. So let's meet in the next lecture. So thank you so much students. Bye bye.